Welcome to this special holiday episode of 41 Nosh. We're at Foodology off of Lasky Road, and joining me today are my BCAN co-workers, BCAN producer Marcus Harrison, Jordan Tomasi, she's our social media promotion specialist, as well as a co-host of Trendy in Toledo, and her co-host is Allie Ray, and also the host of Arts Now. Marcus, we're going to start with you. What are you making? What do you like to make around this time of year?
Well, the holidays is always a special time, so what I'm going to prepare for you this evening is La Grine Soufflé de la France. Actually, that just means green bean casserole. So it's a dish that's not really too difficult to make, but it's something you can whip up. It's definitely a holiday favorite, and you know, that's what we're going to prepare for you this evening.
Jordan, joining you today is your mom, Terry,
yes.
Correct?
And
we're
yes.
going to meet her in a little bit. You have matching aprons.
We do. We have to be very extra when
yeah,
we do anything.
You're going to see that. And for the kids, for the adults out there, extra, what does that mean?
Just means over the top,
over the top,
a little bougie. It's a good thing.
Yeah,
you want to be
trendy.
Extra.
Yeah. What are you guys making?
So we are making my favorite cheesy bread. It is the perfect appetizer for any holiday party. And of course, we're making a honey baked ham, which is a staple in any Christmas.
Okay, we look forward to it. Allie, finally, your dad's joining
yeah,
you, and
yes.
you're taking care of desserts for us for the evening.
We are. I didn't have enough time to go to TJ Maxx for matching aprons, so we're a little more basic, but I wouldn't say I'm making, it's more of my dad is allowing me to over-supervise him, so
okay.
This is mostly my dad's, this is my special favorite thing that my dad makes, so we're gonna see, you guys are gonna also see why it's so special. It's got just a few little extra ingredients in it.
Extra, not the extra, like,
no,
which
no,
is
but
okay.
This is gonna be the best apple pie that you ever have in your life, guaranteed. Hands down.
You guys are gonna go in the kitchen behind me. You'll
yep.
get started, so go ahead.
Right.
Start warming up. We're gonna meet with them in a little bit. But before we go into the kitchen, we are gonna head over to Eric Oblander's house. You know him as the host of Rise Up. He and his mom are whipping up their favorite holiday recipe. Eric, take it away.
All right, thanks, Tim. Hey, you guys look like you're having a great time out there. Speaking of great times, we're here with my mom. We're gonna make some traditional, something that I remember from my childhood and still enjoy now, that we have at Christmas time, and that is what, Mom?
Crepes. My mother is French, you know that. And she would make crepes for holidays, and we'd have the fancy crepes with the fancy fillings.
All right, Mom, here we are. Show me what it takes to make these crepes. What do you got in there?
Okay, we have eggs, flour, milk, vanilla, sugar, and some melted butter.
Melted butter, important, having as much butter as possible.
All right, first off, we're gonna crack four eggs. A little bit more than 2 cups of milk.
Now you're making a half batch or a full batch?
I'm making the full batch.
Cool, because we're hungry.
And then I use about half a cup more.
All right.
So it's about 2.5 cups.
And that keeps them a little thinner probably, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. Whisking like a champ, Mom.
And then you add a teaspoon of vanilla, 1/4 teaspoon of salt. So then 2 cups of flour.
All right, so this is out of here, right?
Yep, that's gone.
All right, this will be my job, cleaning up the area.
Oh, that's a good thing.
What do you think?
So, I also put in about a couple tablespoons of sugar. And then melted butter. This has to sit for like an hour.
All right.
Mix through the batter.
All right, cool. So then we'll just hang out and drink champagne until that's
sounds like a
ready
plan.
To go. All right.
Awesome. Sounds like a deal, Mom.
Yep.
Let's do it. Now what? Cook them?
Now we're going to cook them.
All right, Mom. Let's see you cook.
All right.
What you got?
The first few are probably going to be bad. Okay, pour it in. Swirl it around.
And you try to get that as thin as possible.
Shiny on the top, so it looks almost completely cooked through.
Is that a technical food term, shiny?
Minutes.
Mom knows crepes. That's why she's here. Merry Christmas, everybody.
All right, and there we go.
I'm psyched.
All right, so this is kind of the Wild West when it comes to toppings for a crepe, am I right?
Yes, as far as I'm concerned. And then a little whipped cream.
All right.
So I'm going with plain and a little bit of sugar.
All right, let's give this a shot.
Mmm.
It's like I'm transported to my Christmas youth. Thank you for having us. Thank you for showing us how to make these.
Oh, you're welcome.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
And Happy New Year. All right, Tim, back to you. Happy holidays.
Thank you, Eric. And Eric, he's a master at multitasking, also operating the boom mic for us here tonight. And I assume he's going to be eating some food with us tonight, right, Eric? All right, thank you. Terry, you are Jordan's mom.
I am.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
First of all, tell us how proud of Jordan are you?
She's my girl. She does a great job and we're very proud of her.
What is your contact name and my phone?
Oh, my contact name and her phone is Momager.
So she's very proud.
Very proud.
This is my creation.
Terry, tell me a little bit about your cooking background.
Sure. Well, I'm a corporate trainer by day, but my weekends I love to be an amateur chef. So I love the holidays, I love cooking, and what I have for you today mm-hmm. is the classic ham. But for the holidays, I always like to kind of step it up a little bit and add a little bit of pineapple and maraschino cherries as a garnish. So can I tell you what I've done so far?
Yes, and if I ever can't host a show, can you You seem to have a good handle. I think I can just step away and just eat. But you did get us prepped here. The maraschino cherries, I love that. That's a nice touch.
So before we did that, though, we made a glaze. This is just a fully cooked picnic ham, and we took a glaze with the syrup of pineapple slices, and we mixed it in with some brown sugar and the secret ingredient, some lemon lime cola, and we mixed that together and poured it over the ham. We also added some cloves just for some extra spice. After that, Jordan was my right-hand person, and all we did was took the pineapple rings and with a toothpick just adorned the pineapple rings on the ham and then secured some maraschino cherries in the middle, and it just really, again, gives it that extra special touch for the holidays.
So how many more pineapples are we adding?
Until this is all filled up.
So all filled up.
So Jordan, do you wanna start a little bit?
Oh, yeah.
So we're gonna get started on this.
Yes. Yeah.
How long is this ham gonna go into the oven after we are finished with this?
Well, this is a fully cooked ham, so you just heat it up and it's based per pound. So with this ham, I would say it needs to cook, just warm up for a couple of hours.
Couple of hours.
So really, it's a great dish for the holidays. It's really low maintenance. And what holiday isn't complete with a showstopper ham like this on your dining room table?
Jordan, is this your favorite holiday item?
It is not.
Okay.
I do like ham, but I have to say the cheesy bread we're making is absolutely amazing, so I'm so excited for everyone to try that.
Cheesy bread. Okay, we're going to do
so
a little
good.
Cheesy bread action here in a bit. While you guys keep prepping this, we're going to go meet with Allie and her dad, Dave. As you heard, Allie's making the pie.
Well, semi.
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 Dave, first of all, nice to meet you. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. And this is your recipe, right, for apple pie?
Correct.
What made you get into baking pies?
I don't know, I just love cooking and I love bacon and it just, everybody likes dessert, so.
Are you a dessert person by nature?
I am, okay. I am, my whole family is.
Yeah. More of a pie or like chocolatey or?
More chocolate than anything, but yeah, good pie's good.
Is this a standard item at your holidays and stuff,
yes.
Family gatherings?
Yep.
Very cool. So what part are you working on here?
I'm working on the crust here, and I think that the crust is the most important part, because mm-hmm. if you mess the crust up, it doesn't matter what the flavor is, the crust is.
Absolutely, bad, so. Absolutely. You don't want it too flaky and falling apart.
No. I have a cup of flour, a quarter cup of shortening or butter you can use, and a little bit of salt. For this recipe, it took me 5 years, really, to make it down to where I wanted it, to the flavor I needed it to be, and I actually entered it into a Fulton County Fair.
Did you really?
Won first place for my pie.
You didn't tell me this.
We got an award. Wanted him to tell his story.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
Very cool.
First out of the gate, the lady's like, "How long have you been making pies?" I go, "This is the first time I've been making, made a pie." And she's like, "You got to be kidding me." I'm like, "No." She goes, "Well, you won first place." So I was like, "Well, great."
Allie, I assume the apple pie is one of your favorites.
Well, this is, yeah. So this was my special request. I was asking my dad because I know it takes him kind of a while. I mean, he's got people calling him, friends and family all the time. So I have to like take my slot in mm-hmm. for him to like get me a pie. But no, yeah, this is my favorite thing. Peel it completely. And mm-hmm. then you go ahead and chop all four sides off. After that, you put it in nice, not too thin, because apparently what my father's told me, they melt. So you have to have them nice and thick, which is,
I think,
I've been snacking a little bit mm-hmm. here and there.
But no, this is my favorite dish. I think it is a staple. When it's not apple, blueberry is also a specialty. They're pretty bomb.com, absolutely.
Bomb.com.